All right, now we're back to our lesson. Okay? When the keepers of the house should tremble, the strong men should bow themselves. That means that your lower extremities give up and give out. We have names for that kind of stuff, arthritis and what have you. It's just saying I could use to be. I did used to be jump, get through the rim in the basketball court. Can't do it now. You know, run up and down the court all day, football field, what have you. Just can't do it now. It's like the same stuff that's there.
Some folks broke their ankles trying.
Broke my ankle trying to do that. And the grinders cease because they are few. Those that look out of the window, be dark. So, that's life. That's life. And so the keepers are your arms and legs. Looks at Psalms 147 and 10, dealing with a strong body part. I hope it says dealing with a strong body part. I believe that is. Okay, yeah, it does. And it says a strong body part of men is his legs. He delighted not in the strength of a horse. He take not pleasure in the legs of a man. So that's strength. That's what his strength is. He can go out and work and do everything because his legs is carrying him. Out in the fields, cutting the yard, climbing the ladder, painting the house, just doing what he got to do because his legs is taking him wherever he got to go. He's strong. Strong legs. But after a while, you get in that span of life where your legs is not as strong as they were back in the day. So that's why we fall down on concrete and trip. Catches us by surprise sometimes, but you just ain't got it like you used to have. Some of us fight it all the way to the grave. But life is telling you the story all the time. Praise God. So, now, let's go on a little bit further here. He's going to give some prescriptions, but I don't know if it's here or not. Yeah, it is. It's only verse 5. But let's go with the verse 4 first. Verse 4, listen. How many know Whitney Houston? Can she still sing?
Yeah, she can, but
not as well as
she
used
to. Not like she could back in the way. She can't bring it like she used to. She can tear the house down. So this is what he's getting ready to describe here. And the door should be shut in the streets. When the sound of the grinding is low, he should rise up at the voice of the bird, and all the daughters of what?
Music
should be brought low. Now, here's what we find in here is that old people get up late, or do they get up early?
Early.
Old people get up early because they want their day to be longer. They are going to have some day. So they figure it out. Wake up early, you get more day. So old people wake up early with the sound of the birds. I woke up the other day, it was an owl out there in my front yard. But now you wake up early and you hear the sounds of the birds. But pretty soon, those that can carry a tune can't carry one anymore. That's true. What happened? I used to hold that note for an hour and a half. So that's what he's saying here. And music should be what? Just turn it off. Tired of music. Don't even like music no more. Don't even like the sound of the radio or all that no more. Old folks as you get older, have you noticed that old people don't be wearing iPods walking down the street? You don't see that. music, the sound of it, the rhythm of it and all like that, they can't keep up, so they don't want to hear it. Get rid of it. Check it out. Old folks don't dig music and all that, and stereos and all that. They kind of slow down with jazz. I gotta find me some folks that know what I'm talking about. They don't get into the hip hop. How many like hip hop? Come on, be honest. How many of you guys like hip hop?
Some of them.
But how many of your kids like hip hop?
All of them.
All of them like. The next generation, they all into it. You know, we look at it and go,
what did they say?
Yeah, what? Moving too fast. Didn't you tell me that the other day, brother? Was that you? They're moving too fast. They're talking, singing too fast. Because you go, oh, no, you're just too slow. You're just too slow.
Yeah.
We had those rappers in here Wednesday. How many can keep up with them? That was gone. Too fast, you're just too slow.
No, they're not too slow.
see how they are? They don't want to front, they don't confront, they don't want to face up to
it. That's right.
It's not that we're too slow.
This is not like it used to be. Yeah. Okay, so verse 5. Also, when they should be afraid of that which is high. How many are afraid of heights these days? I used to get up there on anything. Climb a tree. I got on a 6-foot ladder and I'm looking, trying to check it out. How far high am I? Used to climb trees and get on the branch and just hang off and do all kind of crazy stuff. But now, as you get older and more, you get conscious of the fact that, you know what? This is not too wide.
Don't get well too quick.
How many still like roller coasters? How many used to get on a roller coaster?
I used to live on roller coasters.
How many don't get on one now? Things is changing. What's that?
Heart be in your mouth.
Yeah. I can't take it like I used to. It was fun, but that's okay. I get the kids on there. Everybody can go. Go ahead in front of me. all that. Not into it anymore. Things have changed. Okay, praise God. So, and fear should be in the way. That's us. Now, here's some descriptions. The almond tree shall flourish. What is that? All right. The almond tree. You guys ready for this?
Mm-hmm.
You should get gray hair. It's coming no matter what you try and do to it. It's gonna be there. There's gonna be a whole lot of it. And you just can't, you gotta be just there. I'm trying to keep it dark, and you're trying to bring it white, and guess who's winning? God's
winning.
He's just throwing that stuff on you big time. It's like weeds growing in the field, in the grass. Man, I can't get rid of this. It just, more I try, the more it comes. It's on its way. It's just going to do it. So that's what the almond tree should flourish. Now the grasshopper should be a burden. Now think about the grasshopper. If it was a grasshopper in here today, he'd be what? All over the place. You try and catch him, he's all the way over. But all of a sudden, he becomes a burden after a while. Means he needs some help getting around. Guess who that might be, Sister Sylvia? Curtis?
Some of these things you can apply to some people, but you can't apply to
everybody. No. See, because
I like that, Curtis.
Well, we got a mix, but guess what? Grasshopper?
I ain't no grasshopper.
If we live long enough, I would not, at 90, I would not be able. Well, I might, at 90, be able to stand up here and do all this and do all that without any assistance.
Yeah,
not 95, 99.
Not like you used to.
Not like I used to. Curtis won't be able at 99 go, oh, I do all he's doing now. How many hours you work a day now, Brother Curtis?
What, 12, 14?
Uh-huh. See, we go, fight it all the way to the back. But life and nature is going to say, oh, we're going to score.
It's time to retire then.
It's time to retire then. Yeah. Why? Because you feel like going to the beach all of a sudden? No. I'm old. And so this is what he's saying here, that the grasshopper becomes a burden. He needs some help. In and out of the wheelchair, up and down the stairs, around the corner, in and out of bed. Oh, he was a spring chick. She was a spring chick back in the day, but right now we got to do almost everything for her. Becomes a burden. This is what Solomon is saying from his youth on forward. And desire shall fail. So this is talking about sexuality. Desire shall fail.
It's 17 after.
Okay. When I was 17, 18, 19, 20, got married at how young? 23?
You were 23.
I was 23. It's not unusual. Have a desire. Sex 2 or 3 times a day. Well, the Bible finds you no matter where you are. You can hide everything. What verse was that? Oh, verse 5. Man go to his what? Long life. And that's the reason why God made that desire for sex, so we can do what? Repopulate the earth. So that's how he planned it. God's plan, good plan. Except when you can't play on that field all the time. You're going to get old. Because man go to his long home. As far as Solomon was concerned, the long home was the grave. He didn't know anything about eternal life, everlasting life. He just knew that he's going to the grave. This is what he's observing. And as he goes to the grave, the mourners go to the streets. The mourners were professional mourners. That was their job, to come around the funerals and cry and get you all emotional and all like that. I do have some scriptures for lack of time, we won't go there. Yeah. But I believe it's Amos, it's for your, Amos 5 and 16 and Mark 5:38. Those were the professional mourners. When someone died in the family, you knew what house to go to because they had those professional people there, the professional choirs. All right, and then we'll move right on. Are the silver cord be loose? Are the golden bowl be broken? Are the pitcher be broken at the fountain? Are the wheel broken at the chisholm?
System.
And that's a pitcher hanging with water and so forth. And once you cut it and it hits the ground, it's over. And that day will come, if you live long enough, they're just not who they used to be. And if you don't believe that, hang around a nursing home, and you'll find a lot of accomplished people that did a lot in life, but look where they are. You wouldn't even think that's the same person. They're doing all they can to stay out of the grave. But they got to get all the help they can get to stay out of it. They're just not the same person. Not the same strength. They don't even look like they used to look. And that's because this is how it is when she get old. That's the thing. Then shall the dust return to the earth as it what?
As it was.
As it was. Now who's the dust?
Us.
Us.
Our body.
And the spirit returned to who?
God.
That's how it goes. That's how it goes. Nothing you and I can do about it. You're just part of this, and once he gets there, it's there. Man, Williams used to run 4.3. Is that right?
Yeah.
4.3. Man, look at him go. Look at the film. Now look at him. Look at the record. So, he says here, what did he say in verse 13?
Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandments, for this is the whole duty of man.
Let us hear the conclusion of it from start to finish. Start to finish. Let's figure this out. What should I do? Love God, honor him. Because you're going back. Some of us want to live forever, but want to be young, vital forever? Nah, not in the game plan. You don't get faster as you get older. You don't get stronger as you get older. You know, we want to do our best to do contrary to that. We're going to try, and man, just haven't given up yet. But God's plan says this is the way to go. You get older, you get gray. And grayer. Yeah, grayer. Oh, man. No.
But you know, Solomon was writing out of his experiences.
Yes.
And one, we have to look back at Solomon's life.
Mm-hmm.
He was a man of wisdom.
Mm-hmm.
And he had a lot of folly in his young days.
Yeah.
All the wives, yeah. All the concubines, yeah. All the women, all the horses, all the everything that he wanted.
Mm-hmm.
And all the gardens, all the wine, everything.
Mm-hmm.
And then when he said, he looked at all of that, that's when he came to that last verse.
Right. Yeah.
And let us.
Yeah.
All his folly.
Yeah. 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 None of that's going to give you everlasting life.
It's not going to last.
None of that. Your youth won't give you everlasting life, your money, your possessions. None of that's going to give you. He says you better look to God.
Yeah, that's it.
Because that's the only way, you know, because you're leaving here.
Yeah. And you're going to leave it all
there. You're going to leave it
all there.
And you're going to spend a lot more time in the next life than you did in this one.
That's how short is youth. About that?
It's short.